Hi, I just want to show you a new fun folio book that I'll be teaching at Cropping Bug in Lamarck in April. You can call the Cropping Bug to get times and price information on this album. This is made with Echo Park Hello Summer, and I think it's just a fun book for summer. This is just a quick showing of what you have in store for this, what they'll be making in the classes, just a blank book, and then they'll add their own paper of their choice. This is 5.5 by about 8 inches, and this is I think 1.25 inch spine, and this is the back. I did use some die cuts, and most of the rest of this is entirely what was in the paper. I had some cute little flamingo paper. So it opens up like this, and this has glare on it because it's an acetate pocket, which you can see in there. And this has some of the little banners, and I stitched across it with the banners. It's kind of hard to tell with my sewing machine, and added some of the embellishments and added glossy accents. This is just one of the cards that come with it, or cut aparts, and another cut apart with I think it's a Stampin' Up! Tab punch. This side has two pockets, and I used the envelope punch on both of these. So just everything in here is from the cut aparts or the sticker sheet. I did use Tim Holtz die cut. I can't remember. Let me see if I can find it. What I used. It's these. If you can see them here, without the glare, and punched all this and made the holes in them. So these are just some fun pockets that I made, front and back. And this was using one of the cut aparts and just plain on the back. Another cut apart. This opens up. I'll kind of move it so you can see what all of it looks like. And we'll just start over here. This is a pocket with one of the cut aparts that's just stuck in here. This is one that I glued just for embellishment on the back, and another one that I cut apart or cut down and glued to the front of the pocket. And this is a tag, and I made one of the cut aparts, and I used it, made it a tag sticker, and I just put it on a little stick thing that I used. It was in the die cut thing. I'm sure it's not for a stick, but it's what I used it for, and a small tag. This is just some jute ribbon that I tied on there, hot glued and tied on there, and some of the ribbon that was in the kit. This kit and paper were from Country Craft Creations. The tutorial was also from Country Craft Creations, and I'll give a link in it below. This is a waterfall page, and it has a magnet closure, and has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 pieces, slots of paper. I think this is 4.5 by 4. I'm not sure. This is just a belly band on the bottom. Let's see if I can get in a little closer so you can see a little bit more. There. And it has two small tags that pop out, and it has a strawberry for a stopper, and then it has just another sticker. I think this was a cut apart, but I used the back side of it. And down in here for this, I used some gold, non-shiny gold washi tape, just to cover up the craft cardstock. Just another cut apart, part of the paper. This is a sticker with some more tags in it. It's just some jute. And when I finished this, I had absolutely nothing but scraps left. So I used everything I had. And Oh, I did use this. This is a die cut, but it's also from one of the cut aparts. I just punched it out. And this. I left this pretty plain because I think pictures would be, I've got enough embellishments in pictures would be good. I did do the belly band with a front and back cover and then the magnet closure. I used glossy accents on this and on this one. And move over here if you can see this. This is just a mini album in a mini album folio with another magnet closure. I used the same process of just using cut aparts and covering my base with some pattern paper, designer paper, and then cut aparts on each page. And this does what you want to on this one. This one has a pocket with a tag. This one has just a little stopper from the sticker sheet. This one has just some of the little stickers. You can see that. And just says soak up the sun on there. This is just a plain little tag with a cute flamingo, pineapples, and this is just another sheet with flamingos and toucans on the side. So they just stick in here and stack up. This side is a bicycle used that's not glued all the way down. So you can get some tags in here and a large tag and a medium tag and just a little word sticker. It's just kind of fun to use those in here for accent pieces. This is a sack that my embellishments came in from the kit. So I cut it off a little and used the envelope punch, attached a cut apart in it and just a tag that goes in there. And then I used a sticker there, tied some of the blue ribbon that was in the kit. And this is the last page. And it has a vertical pocket, and I used just layered stickers, the scooter with flowers and our paradise, another sticker, and just part of the paper. I think this was a sticker part that I just put down there, and this little toucan on a sticker sheet. I don't know where I think I'm going. I'm going over toward the light, and another tag. I love the Volkswagens. These are just some cards that once you put pictures in, you can, if you want to put pictures on the back or wherever you want to put them. Watermelon card, flamingo card. These are some more stickers and some banner tag stickers that they had, and I just layered some of those up. So that goes back in. Oh, and these are the tab punch, the new small tab punch from Stampin' Up, which I like. I use a lot. And he really just looks cute in there. That's why he's there. And that's this, and it folds up to this with magnets. There's three magnets holding this together. You probably don't need them. I was going to use a gold ribbon on it or elastic thing to put on here versus the magnets, but I already had the magnets on, and still that looks cute. This is on a just pop dotted, or it's not, it's the foam mount. It came this way, and this was a leaf from the sticker set, the doily that was from a card piece that was in the kit, and these are just some scraps I had left over. Of course, these are stickers. So, and on the back was, I fussy cut this out and stuck it into a pocket that I used the envelope punch and just some various stickers and things. This was a cut apart that already had this on, and then I added the lace, or the doily, and some stickers to take it up. So that's it. I'll post the instructions on how to link to the tutorial, and I'll also be doing one, but you can look at Country Craft Creations if you haven't joined. It's a good time to join, and all her tutorials are free. So we're welcome as teachers to share them and use them. And she has a kit, a craftology kit, that you can get once a month. And I love getting all the good stuff. So thanks a lot.